Eric Leandri, co-founder and CEO of Qwant, whose presentation is entitled "The Web as a Whole, Yours to Discover." And it's interesting that it follows on from the Google presentation, because Eric knows a thing or two about the web, having decided to take on Google. He's an experienced web and security software veteran. The Qwant search engine was launched earlier this year in 35 countries and in 15 languages. So much for think big, start small, and scale quickly. It has the edge on Google because it provides a holistic view of the results rather than compartmentalized into news, social, etc. In many respects, it is complementary to Google in that Google is optimized for people who know what they want, whilst Qwant is for those who are open to making new discoveries. So let's give a big hand and discover what Eric has to say.
So thank you, Ed. Thank you, everybody, to stay here after that beautiful presentation of some very good people in the search industry. So Qwant, maybe you don't know anything about Qwant. I will try to give you some information about that new engine, what we do so far since 4 months. We are already online with an alpha version since 4 months. And before everything, I will start talking a little bit about me. So I'm a software engineer, I'm a CEO of Qwant, and in the same time I started working with computers 31 years ago. So I was very young, and at that time it was one of the first personal computers on the market. So like some of you, I started to see the first computer on the market. Like some of us, I started to have a keyboard at 9, 10, and not like today after 2 or 3 years old. So since that time, I never led the keyboards, and since that time, I spent my time on in front of my computer, alone first, and then the web arrived. First of all, the internet arrived. After that, 192, the web arrived, and we are started to be all connected. So the whole idea behind Qwant is continue the idea of interconnection. That is the first idea of internet, and that first idea of internet has been written in 1972. It was the day of my birth. Nothing to do with me, but it's funny. So we start with a small introduction to Qwant. What is the web today according to us? The web today according to us is closing itself. Why is closing itself? Because according to me and according to Qwant's company, we think that actually all the big players on the web are acting like island. They create big, big island, they create big universe, and they don't want to talk to each other anymore. So they close the thing every day. And I know everything about island because I come from Corsica, so it's a small island, and I know exactly what happens when you just want to stay alone in your country. And now I start to add the Mediterranean Sea right here. So the web of today in that direction will become a closed space, that's for sure. And if you want to be free, the whole idea is started to open the space, started to create bridge between the island that are being created actually. So Qwant is a consequence of all of this. We try to make something new. We try to make something for people who like the web, who like the freedom, who wants to have access to everything like before. And we give access to everything on one platform to be sure that you will be able to make your choice by yourself, not in one universe or another universe, but everywhere around the network. So we want to give back power to users. We want to give you the capability of choices. We want to give you the capability of discover new things. The whole idea is about an holistic view of the web. We add our own proprietary algorithms. I will not do technical things today, so I will go through a normal presentation of Qwant. So our idea is about an open philosophy, and I will try to explain you how. This is a presentation of our B2C platform, as soon as I can make it work. So actually, some problems that we see on the web are users cannot see on the same page search and several social search results. For example, you know some big search engine, you go on them, you want to have some information about your social, you don't find it on them, but you go on your social, then you get your information, and then you come back to the search, and then you go to another tweet deck or other things like that to get other information, and then you come back to the web. You know how to use it, that's great, but you have to do several things to use it. Sorry. With Qwant, we want to embrace all the web at once. We want to give you the capability to talk, to send your comment, to create, to search, to create, to share, to do all of this freely and between all the networks and all the platforms on the web today. So the whole idea is about transversal online research. We will research for freedom in the web, in the social web, in the video, in the photo, in the live for news, and in the shopping for people who want that kind of things. And the whole idea is to give all of this in one platform and give you all the API to use it everywhere on your own software when you want. We want to improve a new experience and a new user experiences. So the graphical user interface is different, and so we have to talk about it. There is several key features, and I will try to go directly to them. Let me try this. Let me go further. On the main pages of Qwant, you will be able to make your search right here. We add some hot trends right here. I will explain that to you later. So right now, nothing to do new in the internet looks like a search engine. I'll come back to the last pages after you choose your search. Then you get several things. First of all, the web, the kind of thing that you will find on the usual search engine right now. So don't go anywhere else. You will get everything right here. So just test the pertinence and you will see. Then you have the news. We are all about everything on the live, plus everything on the blogs, or everything coming from the social live. Because right here, you get Twitter, Facebook, Google+, and all the others. So you get the answer from all the social web without being connected to none of them. You can connect to them, but you don't need to connect to them. Then you get some photo videos, and you get some shopping. So on Nelson Mandela, the good news is better, and you get the news seconds by seconds on the social web, and you get the news right now on the web, and so you can refine your search right here, or right here, or right here. That means that when you get that Nelson Mandela is better, you can be sure and see that on real newspaper, we can give you the information. Let me try to go further. So it is a cross-platform search engine that will give you everything in one result, the whole difference. Okay, I will check if it's not mine, and I continue. No, so the whole idea right here is you will be able to get all your information. Maybe it's too much, but our point of view is if I give you everything, one thing that the human brain does better than all the computers in that planet is making a choice. So if you found what you are looking for, you will choose it, and then you just have to refine it or add it on the top. Just try that. So there is a knowledge graph. We add a queue. It's just for humor, but you can get your information about Nelson Mandela if you don't know it. There is a capability to change the languages, and not only the languages, you can change the country, because in reality, if you change languages and country, you will arrive and get the information about Nelson Mandela in South Africa with the tweet and social information from Facebook and Google+ from South Africa. Same thing coming from America, same thing coming from Brazil and the others. You have several views, so if you don't like the classic view, you can go on Mosaic, and Mosaic is the same kind of view. Try it on the web, you will understand it. You have media. Media is a mix between photo and video, because we think that today photo and video are the same and very interesting for everybody. Then you have people. If you are looking for your company, I'm sure that you will find yourself, your LinkedIn, the LinkedIn of your friends, information about your company, your Facebook. If you are looking about you, I'm sure you will find your Facebook, your Twitter, your information about you, your LinkedIn, information about all your companies, and information totally connected. Because the whole idea of all of this is to create object and bring you into the Web 3.0. Making connection between object, making connection between you, your blog, your website, your social life, your real life, and everything about you. And your company and everything you want to see. Wow. Another thing on Qwant, you can bookmark everything. You can create your own Tumblr-like experience, or you can create your notepad, like we call it. So that means that everything that you have found, you can add it on a page, you can collect it, you can add it, you can create some new blogs. You can install that kind of creation inside of your blogs. You can share this, you can share that to everybody. You can follow somebody, you can see what the others are looking for, and if you are looking for an expert of something, you certainly found some very good bookmarks of very good expert. And if you are looking for Dior, you will find some beautiful bookmarks of very expert in fashion and clothing. So you have hot trends. What is hot trends? Actually, hot trends start to be a new things on the internet, but 4 months ago, before we start, nobody does that kind of things. A trend comes from the whole web. So you can have information from the social web, you can have information from the search engine, or you can have information from video websites like YouTube and the others. And if you click on one of these information, you will get all the data about one word. So if you have an hot trend with Nelson Mandela, you get all the information about him. And if you have an hot trend about the Utah, what is her name, Miss Utah, who makes, for example, a fantastic answer to several questions. I hope I will not do the same when Ad will give me some questions. So for those who haven't seen that video, you should go there and you will find who is that girl, what she has done, and what she says during her interview. Another thing, every time you will click on a social thing, Twitter, Facebook, or everything, you will be able to answer to anybody. So even if you don't have a Twitter, go on Qwant, you can answer to somebody and make contact with him. Good thing with that, you are in Saint-Tropez, you want to know where Rihanna is right now, just type Rihanna or Saint-Tropez and Rihanna in social, you will find people who say that she just entered Dior boutique. Ask him if it's true, ask her if it's true, and if it's true, you can go and see her there. It's a 2 seconds way of contacting people. Then another thing, you can share that everywhere. You can do that for Twitter, you can do that for Facebook. The only universe where you can't do that, it's our good friend who just left. We can do it technically, but it's just legally that they don't let us do it. So we wait, we ask. You can do shortener of all the things that you have seen, so bookmarks and everything. You can share that on your Twitter in one click, very easily. And let me come back to the beginning. So what we want to do with that, just bring back the web where it was before big groups start to close it. The whole idea here is look at Qwant, look what you can do when you open everything, look at all the answers that you can't find, just the only way for you to find them are go on your Twitter, go on your Facebook, go on your search engine, go everywhere, make your search. Here, you will find it in 2 seconds. Another good thing here, try your village, try the home where you come from, you will see your friend talking, you will see information about your village that you can't find nowhere else. Because when you have just 10 answers or 20 answers on one pages and all made by search engine optimization, it starts to be very difficult to have a very good news for a small part of that world. So when it's about local, when it's about new things, when it's about connecting people you don't know, when it's about things you want to have right now and right there, the only solution is to start making bridge between island. And so we want to do the bridge between island, and we want to share that. We want to give you capability on our B2B start. We have a real-time analytics and service platform for big data, but we will give you API for free for small startup and for some amount of money for big companies. And all that technology and that API can give you the capability to create new applications with all the Facebook result, all the Twitter result, all the Google Plus result, plus all the news result, all the web, photo and video in 1 second. An example, we signed FC Barcelona with our technology, so we are the search of FCB Connect. So we have the search of FC Barcelona. You can get all the information about the player and all the people who talks about that and all the photo and all the video in a search dedicated to FC Barcelona. We do the same with Real Madrid, and we done the same 1 week ago with Flamengo. We do exactly the same for country. So we start with 3 countries. It's not finalized yet, but it will be soon. So you will know all the country. We can start their own white label search engine. Beyond Qwant, some technologies, API, a lot of things that I have talked about already. And I have no idea how many times I would have yet. So the whole idea behind Qwant is give that kind of technology to everybody very easily. And we want to promote an ethic. We want to follow the European privacy for everybody. So on Qwant, no cookie, just the session cookie. We will not register what you are doing. If you connect to Qwant to create your bookmark and everything, at every time you can disconnect, and we will just erase all the information that you bring to us. We'll not use us. We'll not use that kind of information. We don't need all of this to make our business. And above all, we want the liberty of users against artificial boundaries that start to be created all around the internet. So we want to grow with your critics and as well as your suggestions. So please send me emails and suggestions on contact@qwant.com. Thanks for listening.
That was a very self-contained, self-explanatory. It's answered most of my questions. But how are you going to monetize this?
Like I try to explain to you, but I perfectly understand that my fantastic English is very difficult to understand. My point, I used to practice in Africa with Indian people, and I come from Corsica, so please forgive me. So the real idea behind Qwant is we create search engine, and we create white label search engine, and we create API. So for example, for FC Barcelona, we give them the capability to have a search and give them the capability to get all the information about their fans, because they are the fans of FC Barcelona at all. And so they want to keep in touch with their fans, give them the maximum information, and in the same time, they need information from them to do their job like they do for years. So we give them all of this, and we get some money behind that. And we have a B2B capabilities of giving a search engine to the internet, because we are the search engine of Yellow Pages France, 1,200,000,000 average return. We are the search engine of Mythic, and we are the search engine of French Department of Defense. But again, don't worry. We are not here to control you, follow you. It's absolutely the opposite philosophy.
Okay, well, thank you, Eric. Thank you
very much.